There shouldn't be a volcano here. And yet, there is not just one, but two of them in close proximity to each other. Welcome to the remote Russian Arctic, where, at 76 degrees north latitude on Zhokov Island, temperatures plunge to negative 30 degrees Celsius in winter months and are still largely at or below freezing temperatures even during the hottest summer months. It is quite an inhospitable place. And yet, not only did humans visit this island as much as 8,000 years ago, leaving behind obsidian artifacts, but this island's geology is quite unique. While heavily eroded to look far older than it actually is, Zhokov Island in particular represents a now-extinct stratovolcano of a primarily basaltic composition. This volcano ceased erupting around the same time West Maui's shield volcano ended its post-shield phase eruptions. The time frame I'm referring to is 1.2 million years ago. Yet, looking to the south, an additional member of the remote Daelong Islands also contains evidence of recent volcanism, as on Vilkitsky Island, extrusive volcanic rocks have been dated to as recently as 400,000 years old, which is far more eroded despite its younger age. The other three islands in the chain are also volcanic, but have not likely produced an eruption for upwards of 15 million or more years. It is quite difficult to get a clear-cut picture of the history of either of these two volcanoes, but here is what we do know about Zhokov Island in particular and its geology. Zhokov Island measures 10.1 kilometers or 6.3 miles long and 8.2 kilometers or 5.2 miles wide. It has an area of 59 square kilometers and is completely unpopulated. The strange shape of this island becomes a bit more clear how it originated when I mark not only the seven volcanic cones present, which are a mixture of cinder cones and stratocones, but also what appears to be buried flank vents from the tallest peak on the island towards its west. The rest of the surface rocks represent lava flows from these various vents combined with eroded material of the same origin. This volcano erupted between 10 million and 1.2 million years ago, but since this volcano erupted on a fairly shallow plateau, eruptions were probably quite infrequent across its entire active period. The vents which would form seemingly followed two separate trends which give us a clue about the island's origin. The first north-northeast trend perfectly parallels the orientation of the Gackle Ridge spreading center where the North American plate is spreading apart from the Eurasian plate. It is possible the uneven motion of this divergent plate boundary or its interaction with more distant plate movement caused stress to transfer to the east, forming a series of small rifts that allowed magma to intrude into the crust and occasionally produce eruptions along a parallel axis. This plate boundary is known as the slowest moving on Earth, which correlates quite well to the unusually low rate of post-middle Miocene eruptions in the vicinity. As for the east-northeast orientation, it parallels the orientation of an older Fulden thrust belt. In other words, whatever originally caused magma to rise into the crust here simply at times used this secondary axis involving numerous faults as a path of least resistance to travel upwards to the surface. While some sources suggest that an underlying mantle plume is the source of these isolated extinct volcanoes, potentially with a link towards the Cretaceous Age High Arctic Large Igneous Province, I am not too convinced as this link seems somewhat weak to me. There could be a hotspot, but in my opinion, rifting is a more likely culprit. One piece of evidence for my hypothesis is the fact that a highly unusual rock type was found on Zhokov Island, a rock type known as Limburgite. Limburgite is essentially basanite lava rock but contains no feldspar, often being found in rift-related geologic settings. However, an argument against my hypothesis is the finding of what is described as semi-abundant mantle xenoliths on Zhokov Island, with such inclusions being more likely from a mantle hotspot origin. So, what do you think about this remote and extinct Arctic volcano? Be sure to let me know in the comments section below. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube for supporting my work.